Hi guys, my name is Dave Pishko and I'm happy to be tying this fly for everybody to see. It's one of my favorite mouse patterns to fish here in Alaska on the Nushagak and also on the lower 48 on the Yellowstone River. It's been a productive pattern and I hope you guys enjoy the video. I'm gonna first start out by doing a thread base. Start a little bit behind the eye. Just wrap that up towards the back. I always like to get a good thread base down before I start anything. It's just kind of secures everything. Doesn't allow your material to slip. Thread is cheap, so don't be afraid to use a little bit of it. I'll go to about the barb of the hook is my stopping point. And from there, I'm going to tie in a tail. This is basically just kind of a rubber band style tail. I like it because it moves pretty good in the water. It's durable, it's like elastic. And I'll just capture it and kind of work my way back up the shank. And if it doesn't lay on there perfectly, you can adjust it. As I'm coming back, I'm just making sure it's on the top of my shank. Sometimes they'll want to roll on you, so you just kind of got to hold it in position. As I come back up, I'm torquing down with more pressure all the way to the back barb of the hook. I'll just trim off my excess. Next step, we're going to use some beaver hide, strip down into like a magnum size rabbit strip, just say for an example, and I'll cut a little point for a tie-in point. I have the hide facing towards me right now, and it'll be easier as I wrap that front. And as I capture this in, I'm really locking this down with some pressure. And then I will advance myself all the way to the front where I'm gonna stop, just behind the eye. Next step, I'm gonna put a little foam in here, just a little square chunk, just helps with a little buoyancy. And I'm gonna trim it down just a touch. Put that on there and you can just capture it down. It's gonna shrink up a little bit. It's gonna kind of want to segment on you. Just get it nice and tight on there, forming the body of the fly. And the foam color doesn't really matter. This is black, it's just something I had handy. I'll advance that. My next step is I'm gonna take this beaver hide and I'm gonna wrap it, kind of palmering the hair back, and I'm kind of touching each section as I come up. And I'm also pulling down pretty tight on this hair. Wrapping it all the way up to the front. Some of it will kind of want to lay weird, but you just kind of keep working it back. If you have to wet your fingers to make it part, don't be afraid to do that. Once I get up close, I will capture that. A few loose wraps. Then I will come in front of it, secure that off, and we'll tie it. Trim off the excess. And I'll just make a nice little bump here in front of the, or excuse me, behind the eye. Clean it up. Get a nice, hard, smooth wraps in there, cleaning everything up, just like that.
So what's the thread, Dave?
This is the thread I'm using is 150 denier vivus in black. Black's just, you could even use white if you had it, and you could use a Sharpie to color it whatever color you wanted to. I had black laying here, so it will work for our, what we're doing. Couple of whip finishes on there, cut it. I always like to use some glue. This is hard as hull here. Cement this down. I like to hold the hairs back because when this glue gets on there, it likes to just try to catch everything. And I like to glue it pretty good. I mean, I'm building this fly to fish and I want it to last. So I try to make it as durable as I can. I'll just kind of glue it on each side. And that is the back half of the fly. This is gonna be an articulated pattern. So we'll let that hang out for a second and dry. My next step is the front half, and this is just a shank. It's a number two shank, and I just cut the back off. And basically I line it up in here to basically show you how big I want the body. And that's pretty close right there. Again, we'll start with the thread, and this is going to be a deer hair head. So I'll start my thread where I want to stop the rest of my material, and from the here up is going to be deer hair. That leaves me a reference point to say, okay, don't go any farther than this, or else you're going to crowd your head. Again, I'll just cover this with some thread, make a good base. Okay, like so. Now I'm gonna grab some 65 pound Power Pro, and I like to use Power Pro because it's pliable. When Power Pro gets wet, I'm trying to think of the word for it. It's stiff right now, like it's standing up and down. When this gets wet, it'll just kind of get really flexible, and it allows this fly to really move around. It's like it's coming alive. I don't like to use wire because I think wire is stiff and you don't get the action out of wire as you would this Power Pro. This is your lifeline. Power Pro is braid. And why I call it my lifeline is if you don't tie this in tight enough and this comes off, there goes your fish. So this is a lifeline. I like to start it right on top of my shank. Kind of loose wraps, and I can move this now. You don't want this way too big because this thing will really come around itself and get caught up. I like about a quarter inch of gap for my articulation point, and that kind of prevents itself from, some people like to call it a meatball or a chicken nugget or whatever you want to use. I like to basically have a quarter inch gap here for my articulation point, and then I'll just bring this up to my stopping point. I will fold this back, go back towards the butt of the shank. And now I'm gonna add some glue. Coat this up with glue, and then I'm gonna wrap over the top, really securing everything in. I always like to hold the back portion of my fly just so it's on top, just so I know it's there. And I will come up, and I'm really using force here, guys. I'm really pulling down. I do not want this thing to come apart. And I will go back and forth here at least 5-6 times, kind of building a little body with it. And then I'll take what's left of my Power Pro and I'll just fold it back up. Clean that up, and we'll be on to the next step. Okay, next step, we're gonna add some more foam.
My God, unbelievable.
Trim that down. And we're gonna lash this on to the shank, just like we did the back. Like so. Next, I'm gonna go back, grab my next piece of beaver. I'm gonna cut a point in this, tie-in point. Oh, yeah. And just so you can see what I'm doing here, it's just a little tag point. And then the leather strip is facing me. And you can tie it, I like to put it on the side so I can see it. You can put it on the top if that's easier for you, but I like it on the side, it doesn't matter. Really lash that down. And I'm gonna stop it right here at the end. Palmer it back each wrap. If you have to wet your fingers, just wet it. Pulling tight each turn. You don't want this stuff to slip or spin on you. This is all important. And it's okay if some of the hide shows. When this gets wet, it's all gonna fold back and it's gonna look natural. I'll get it to my point. I'll tie this in, capture it some loose wraps, pull down, lock it in, put some wraps in front of it, and we'll cut this off. Hopefully without cutting our thread. I'll come back, I'll hold this back, and I will clean this up. Okay, and this is the body of your mouse. Trim this up a little bit here. Just like so. Now I'm gonna take some gray deer hair and I'm just gonna grab a few clumps, cut it off. And with deer hair, there's some under fur in it. You can use a comb to comb this out, but I like to just pick it out, saves time. This fly isn't trying to win a competition. This is to catch fish. I'll cut the tips off like that. I'll just kind of pick a little under fur out of it. Doesn't have to be perfect. I like to, if you want a cheap way to stack it, just take the palm of your hand and just kind of even up the tips that way. Take a clump like that, and it's about maybe the width of a pencil. Place that right on top of your shank. Loose wrap, kind of pull down a little bit. Second wrap, capture it. Third wrap, just broke our thread. That's okay. Sometimes it happens. We'll just gather this back up. I like to really pull down on my deer hair. It helps it kind of lock it in place. I'll just go over that, recut it. Okay, that's the top half. I will also pack some hair on the bottom side here. That's our next step. Same type clump, about a pencil width. Clean it out. Cut the tips off. Now I'll just flip this on a rotary vise, just spin her upside down, lay it right on top, kind of pack this in. One wrap, second wrap, pull her down, third wrap, really secure that. You can go through it, now rotate my vise back around, and then I'll move this hair back, and I'm gonna walk my thread, kind of just try not to trap too much, moving up towards the front. I'll take my fingers and I'll push this back because we're gonna add another two clumps to it. I'll throw a few wraps in front of this to try to hold that hair back. Oops. Same thing, just kind of pick all the under fur out. Lay this right up on top. I like to do when I get close to the eye, I like to hold this hair on an angle. kind of not a 45, but it's close. And I'll just bring this up and over, one wrap, two wraps, and it might spin. There's a little bit of thread there, and it's okay if it doesn't. We're gonna put a little clump on the bottom yet. Two wraps, third one, give her a good pull. Flip her upside down. Trim that off. Lay this right up in here. Same thing, one wrap. I'm watching that I don't trap too many fibers. Give it a pull, you see it's kind of making a bushy mess. That's what you want. Rotate your vise back, kind of keeping pressure on my bobbin here. I'll make one more wrap, trying to come up through here, not trapping too many. Leave it down, and now what it'll take, I'll do, I don't have a packing tool, but I'll just use my fingers, kind of push this back, getting it all nestled into place, exposing my eye. I'll make a loose wrap up there, another loose wrap, and I'll push this back even more, just so I get a nice built up finished head. I'll use my fingers and I'll just kind of hold this back, and now I'm gonna finish by putting a nice little thread base above the, or behind the eye. Trying not to capture as many. Sometimes you have to work with it. Deer hair gets kind of finicky at times. Don't be afraid to just push on it, move it how you want it. And this doesn't have to be perfect. I just like to get a good thread base behind this eye so I get a good glue point. Okay. Now there's a few ways to do this. If you crowded your eye, you can add a little glue to your thread, and I'll show you guys this way. This is just another way to secure it if you don't get good whip finishes. Hold your thread out and just dab a little glue on that thread. Hold this back and just wrap it all the way up. Okay, I'll just do some whip finishes on here just for some extra strength. And it's okay if a few hairs get trapped in there. We're gonna trim this up. You know, you can do 5 to 10, whatever you feel. Cut your thread off. Now I'm gonna do my final gluing at the end, but there's your rough fly. Now I'm gonna take a double-edged blade. I always trim it from the bottom first. And what I like to do, if you just went in here like this, it's gonna cut it, but it's also gonna cut the body of your mouth. So I like to wet this and pull this beaver hide down. So that way, when I go through with the blade, you're not cutting everything. I'll just hold it flat, and I'll come into it slowly. Take a first cut, see what it looks like. Trim up a little bit more, making that flat on the bottom. This mouse pattern, you can fish either way. It doesn't matter if it's top, bottom, sideways. There's no right or wrong way for this thing to land in the water. It will fish either way. Once I have my bottom trim flat, I'm gonna come to my top, and these blades are flexible. They'll move, you know, either way, so I like to put a little crown in it, and I'll just kind of gently go up and start making the head. Now she's coming to life. And I'll just slowly just keep taking little bits at a time, making sure I'm not cutting my beaver hide, flattening this out like a mouse head, right to the back. And it doesn't have to be perfect, guys. This is just getting a little bit nitpicky now. Just like that. So now I'll take my scissors and I'll just kind of round out. I like to leave a little bit long. Could be some whiskers, some flingers in there. I'll do the same for this side. Trim it up, clean my front up a little bit. And there it is, guys. This is the Midnight Mouse. And the last step, you'll see the shank here. We don't want this guy sticking out like that. So just take your lineman's pliers or side dikes, whatever you want to call it, and just kind of come down. Watch that you don't nick your Power Pro. Cut that off in the can. And there it is. Quick little mouse pattern that you can fish this either way. And when this gets wet, all this hair will wet down and it will look like a mammal swimming across the river.